Sniper Elite V2, short game review. You take on the role as Carl Fairburn, out to stop the Soviets from getting their hands on German V2 rockets. And yes, that is also the plot of the first one. This is basically a remake. In some ways better, in some ways worse. Certainly, it's got much better graphics, but it's made easier in some ways with health regeneration and checkpoint saving rather than having to choose when to save and being encouraged not to save too often, as there is, you know, a point benefit to it. And things that should have been fixed really aren't particularly. It's fairly basic in stuff like, you know, cover systems, the cover system and the like, the third-person shooting outside of just, you know, shooting in this game outside of sniping is not terribly good. The game has both co-op and multiplayer, and the co-op allows for completing the entire campaign. And in fact, once you've completed a campaign level in co-op, it'll also have been completed in single player and vice versa. The co-op also has the modes of bombing run and where you have to gather parts to repair the vehicle that you have to escape in whilst, you know, in the middle of a war zone and enemy patrols might show up anywhere at any time. And Overwatch, where one player is the sniper and the other player is an agent having to get from, you know, one place to another and, you know, somewhat acting as the spotter for the other. Very stealth-based. It also has the mode Kill Tally, and that mode is, in fact, just in general, yeah, it, you know, you have to survive for as long as possible. Yeah, what I'm getting at is also there in singular, and I believe also multiplayer. And yeah, you have to survive for as long as possible, stack up as many kills as possible. The multiplayer has several modes that are interesting enough, such as one where you only get points once you've collected dog tags off the targets you've sniped, one where basically points are earned by how far the, you know, the distance. However, it does tend to just end up as camping matches with the most powerful, most skilled players dominating the others. There is the dynamic mode of capture the flag, where, you know, capture the flag with all snipers can get kind of interesting, but I don't know why they didn't bring back the assassination mode from the first one, where one team protects a target, the other team has to, you know, assassinate that target. I never got to play it because the, you know, co-op and multiplayer in the first is no more, but it sounds a lot like a similar mode in Assassin's Creed, and yeah, that would be a lot more interesting than just the deathmatch and team deathmatch and this with sometimes slightly different rules.
If you like this review and want a more detailed one, the link will be in the description box.
Please rate and comment, and hey, if you like this video, that subscribe button's just waiting for you to click it.